Jesus, oh, welcome everyone to this, our Spectrum concert, a cabaret performance of all that is happening here within our music program, our theater program, indeed, our arts program here at Pitt Greensburg. We are delighted that you have come to be with us on a great journey across many styles of music, from contemporary pop to great masterworks to intimate Renaissance works, to be hearing music of yesterday, of the 20th century, going back into the 16th century, and even singing on texts that were written way back, medieval texts by sinfully rich Galliards in the cabaret. And we're looking forward to being able to share all it is that we're doing, and in fact, all is it that we will be doing very, very soon. Because as we know, in our current era of online advertisement, is that it's what you're doing and what you're doing next that we're always paying attention to. So tonight isn't very much about what we are all sharing in now, but what we also can't wait to be able to bring you in just a few weeks' time for our spring musical, and then when then many of us get to join the Westmoreland Symphony at the end of April to be able to sing with the symphony. So this is going to be a lot of all that we are. We started with how we're going to sing with spirit, and by the time we finish this evening and we sing on, we hope you agree that you want to continue to be able to hear us and so many sing on. Our next set is from our chamber singers, and we go back to the late 16th century for William Byrd's Mass for Three Voices, one of many masses he wrote very much in secret, one that he couldn't share very openly for ceremonies that were kind of done undercover at the time. And this is one of our most favorites. So we're going to sing for you now three movements from the Mass for Three Voices. Thank you. greatest pleasures I have had in this last year is watching the students of our music program involved, both within and reaching out to our community, to say, I want to do this, and thus they made it happen. For the very first time this year, we have on our campus distinct voices, an a cappella group devoted to contemporary arrangements of great music, rock and pop and hip hop and so many more. And they made their debut on the voice and piano recital just this past December. They then changed over a little bit when a couple people left campus and some new ones came. And so thus, this is their re-debut here on our stage. And it is my incredible delight to be able to sit back with all of you and enjoy their music making as much as I hope you will. So please join me in welcoming Distinct Voices.
Thank you.
taken on and gave wonderful performances of great masterworks of Foray and Handel. They've taken on just recently a tremendous piece. If you were here in the fall, you might have heard them sing the Benjamin Britten Hymn to St. Cecilia, one of the true treasures of the choral repertoire, and they made it their own and sang it wonderfully. They toured a year ago through, actually through a lot of the same weather we're having right now, in the middle of spring and ice and all kinds of good stuff. But they have been extraordinary people and extraordinary singers together. And it meant that in this last year they got noticed, and the Westmoreland Symphony came to us and said, would you please come partner with us to sing the Carmina Burana? And if you don't know the whole Carmina Burana, which is a work of 25 pieces set in Latin and French and in German, there are texts that are dating back to Galliard poets who were street poets, street musicians who had a thing or two to say about life, love, and the priest that dominated of their time. So there's a lot of kind of like real body texts that are within. If you don't know the whole work, you probably know O Fortuna at the very end, if you've ever seen a commercial for like a Penguins game or WrestleMania or a bunch of other things. You'll know O Fortuna when you hear it. But it's a wonderful work, and we are looking very much forward at the end of April to partnering with Seton Hills Una Voce and with the Westmoreland Symphony Chamber Singers, and also with the Westmoreland Symphony itself, soloists from the Pittsburgh Opera, to be able to bring 100 strong in the choir to a performance on April the 27th in the Palace. It's going to be absolutely terrific. And we'd like to share with you this evening a little preview of some of the work that we will be doing. But I also want to let you know that my pride in chorale extends back many years. It extends back to, this is now 11 years, a chance to be able to work with so many fine singers. And many of them continue to remain connected into our program. They have come back and sung with us, supported us, continue to be our family and our friends. We've started a tradition in these last few years of coming together to sing If Music Be the Food of Love, which we will sing at the end of the program. But I was speaking to one of our graduates over the summer, and she suggested, what if we came back and we did a program? What if we did like a whole set of music did some of a piece or two that we had done before? Wouldn't that be amazing to put together an alumni choir? I said, yes, absolutely. Would you sing it? She said, I will come down from Boston and I will make sure that I am a part of it. And she so did not. But that's okay. Megan, it was a great idea. We hope you're checking us out in Break a Leg this weekend. I am very, very pleased, though, to again be sharing the stage with some of the finest folks, people that I have ever known for chorale, and just the finest people I have ever known. One that meant a lot to them back when they toured is by Daniel Pinkham. It's called Awake, O North Wind. And before we sing from Carmina, we'd like to offer this as alumni choir together.
Can we preface this with, we didn't know we had to follow that? Throw that out.
Thank you. Thank you. carite remedio.
Amoris crescente.
Carite remedio.
Abuso procuterio.
Abuso procuterio.
Fitudus ineffabilis membris lacertis labilis.
Fitudus ineffabilis membris lacertis labilis. Si! Pue cum puellula morare torin cellula. Thank you.
breaking news. Chorale is proud every year to be able to give two awards to members of the chorale. One is, they're both named for Joan Zaleskowitz, the late wife of Dr. Tad Zaleskowitz, who gave these two awards and scholarships to members of our choir and is still presided over by the family of Dr. Z. One is for service to the chorale. If looking back over the past year of chorale members who have given of themselves to our chorale experience, and the other one is the scholarship award that looks forward into the next year, a rising sophomore with the ability to be who's going to continue on in chorale. And because I just found out about the awards, I can now let you know who will be honored at honors convocation. So they don't even know yet. So. The Service Award looks back over the last year in giving to make the chorale experience what it was. We have so many worthy candidates that are within the chorale, but this year our award winner is Maddie Jackson. She's our fundraising chair and has done so much to be able to ensure that we can do our things now to go on tour again. It's been really wonderful. Our second one is for a rising sophomore and will involve chorale participation in all next year, which is outstanding. One of the reasons it took a while for our reviewers to be able to come back with me is that they said that they saw three extremely worthy candidates who had applied for the scholarship, and they talked a lot about it, but they have ultimately decided that next year's winner will be Jenna Marodi. So we will be at honors convocation in mid-April. It is also one of my great delights to be able to talk to you about those who reach the finish line. And it's kind of funny to talk about it here today because we're not really close at all to the finish line. We are here in March. We have Young Frankenstein coming up in 2 weeks. We are doing Carmina Burana on graduation day. The very day that our graduates will be walking, we will then that night go to the palace to be able to perform. Which means we've got a lot of stuff still in front of us, but this is the last time that chorale is together on our home stage together, and this is the right time to be able to honor. We have one senior who's going to be walking in a little bit. Nicole Hill, would you come down here, please? Arts. I've had a chance to work with her a lot over the last few years, and it's very clear that she is ready to move on from me, because she lets me know all the time, you know, you always put me in the same seat every single year. We do a who stands next to whom for a seat. You always put me in the same seat every year. What was the other day? It was I got new glasses. I was all excited. I came with my new glasses. Do you all think, what do you think of the way my glasses look? Everybody's like, oh yeah, they're good. She's like, man. Chris, I'm going to go to the stage now. I know you're in the middle of doing these things. I just got to kind of check my outfit. Thank you. So she came on out. I say all these things in jest, but I got to tell you that it is this finish, this end that we are doing together that has been the most exciting. Nicole has been a leader within chorale and within our performing arts. She's serving as choreographer for the musical, and we are dancing like our feet are on fire because of all that she has brought. But saw this even a few years earlier when chorale danced together when we did our musical presentation of HMS Pinafore and other numbers that are on there. And it has been a wonderful pleasure to be finishing here with you as colleagues, now being able to work together as a great friend, as a wonderful singer, and as a graduate of the university. Please join me in congratulating Nicole Hill. Performances here come fast and furious because in 2 weeks, right next door at Ferguson Theater, the Greensburg Theater Company will be presenting Young Frankenstein, and we are very much looking forward to bringing this presentation to the stage. Fans of the original film, the Mel Brooks film, who are out there, I was thinking about it a lot last night and how much I enjoyed way back watching Gene Wilder stab himself in the leg. I am for the preservation of life! In this very Gene Wilder kind of way, and the show was adapted as a musical by Mel Brooks himself, and it is wonderfully funny. It is racy. It is frenetic. It is danced well, sung well, played well, all from beginning to end. And we are looking forward to being able to give you the whole show. But as we've done for many of our other musicals tonight, is a preview in the form of a medley. We'd like you to meet our characters, meet our cast, and get introduced to our story. So this is a medley of Young Frankenstein.
You can have it, you can see, it's just a fantasy. But please don't mind. We found the events in the dream. Up until now, it's been a worse time. But now that you're here, we're a team. Together again for the first time. Haven't a woe or a care. No longer a bad and a cursed mind. It's easy to see, you have to agree. We're destined to be a great pair. Take it!
All of my life I've been bossing around. Meaning alone like a Scrooge. All of my life I've been bossing around. But what good is a boss if he ain't got a Scrooge? Oh, I'm sorry. I don't wish to embarrass you, but I have a rather brilliant turn and perhaps can help you with that hump.
What hump?
Must toe the family line. Join the family business. Join the family business. Join the family business. For your name is Frankenstein. Meet your family.
Join the family business. Join the family crime. Make yourself a monster,
and then you'll make his crime.
Listen to your great grandfather Mordecai.
Join the family business. For if you don't want to die.
As you know, predestination from the day of your creation has determined your vocation. That's a fact.
Because you are a Frankenstein, you have no choice. You've got to
sign the truth. It's time to sign the family pact.
My boyfriend!
I go. The monster's awake. We have to create a diversion and fast before he gets out.
Forget about the foxtrot. Throw away the waltz. Take away the two-step and all that other schmutz. Are you ready for what's been going on? If not, then let me explain to you. Yes, sir, it's Transylvania Mania. Whether you're in Ruritania or a dance hall in Albania, yes, sir, it's a Transylvania Mania.
Have you heard about the mania? If not, then let me explain to you. Yes, sir, it's Transylvania Mania. Whether you're in Ruritania or a dance hall in Albania, yes, sir,
what is now our annual song, If Music Be the Food of Love.